Usapan natin. Naririnig ko po yung terms na due process and in very layman's term, yung makinig muna bago humusga. Hindi po ba? Tapos yung probable cause, no? Determination of probable cause. Basically, tama ho ba? Ang hinihingi nyo sa amin, magkaroon ng preliminary hearing para i-determine precisely kung nagkaroon ng ang house ng determination ng probable cause o hindi.
Wala na po, because that was denied already.
Okay.
So when we requested for, when we moved or requested for a preliminary hearing, there was already this resolution of January 18.
Sige po. So now you're asking us
to allow. Oh, I'm sorry.
Go ahead, sir. Doon naman papunta yung question, okay. Please.
We were praying for the liberality of this court and its magnanimity to allow us to present evidence, even on a trial on the merits, to prove our point, Your Honor, and which we were not able to do because our motion, yes, for a preliminary hearing was denied, Your Honor.
And sir, what you want to prove is that walang determination ang house ng probable cause, ergo, it's a violation of the due process of your client, the impeached official, the Honorable Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. In a nutshell, ho, go ahead po.
Not only that it is a violation of the due process right of the accused, Your Honor, but it is a constitutional mandate on the part of our judicial department that the accused should be entitled to due process. Notify him, allow him to be heard, and then decide the case.
Okay. Sir, the reason I ask this question is because I am sympathetic in general.
Thank you.
And I always use the example that we use in law school na ang Diyos nga mismo eh. Nakita niya na kinain ni Eva at Adan yung mansanas, pero hindi niya kagad hinusgahan. Tinanong niya, di ba, ba't kayo nagtatago? Anong ginawa niyo? So before he condemned, he asked them a question. Having said that, Your Honor, if we look at Article 11, Accountability of Public Officials, Section 3, Paragraph 4, no? In the case of verified complaint or resolution of impeachment is filed by at least one-third of all of the members of the House, the same shall constitute the articles of impeachment, and trial by the Senate shall forthwith proceed. So my problem, Your Honor, in being sympathetic with your plight is this. If we granted you a preliminary hearing, or if we allow you to present evidence now, saan to pupunta? Pag nag-ruling po kami na walang probable cause or walang determination of probable cause or hindi kayo dininig ng lower house or ng House of Representatives, sorry to use lower house, the House of Representatives, we will be in effect amending the Constitution. We will be now saying that mali ang paragraph 4 ng Section 3 ng Article 11 because we will be basically telling the House kailangan nyo mag-hearing muna. May I finish, Your Honor?
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
But it is very clear here that when you have one-third of all members signing the verified complaint or resolution, it shall automatically constitute an article of impeachment. So unlike a case in the fiscal's office na kailangan ng piskalya i-inform pareho, makinig sa parehong side, and then determine whether or not meron probable cause, in the case of paragraph 4, pag binasa ng congressman at pinirmahan at umabot sila ng one-third, yun na po ang determination ng probable cause. The Constitution itself does not call for... I'll let you give your side, Your Honor, after this. No? But just to elaborate, and please tell me if mali ang pagkaintindi ko or kung you have a different theory about... specifically, I'm talking about paragraph 4, no? Dahil ako'y naniniwala this is the mode na inakyat sa atin ang impeachment, no? So Your Honor, pag binasa ng congressman to, pag umabot ng one-third, diretso na to sa Senado. Pag hindi to umabot ng one-third, nagkakaroon ng proseso sa lower house under paragraphs 1, 2, and 3. During the impeachment of President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, Congressman T.G. Gengona here, myself, Congressman Joel Villanueva, then Congressman, now Senator Chis Escudero. Ito po tanong namin kay ano eh, sa mga kadibate namin on the opposite side. Sabi namin sa kanila, do you mean kahit na napakalakas ng final namin resolution, kahit klarong-klarong may probable cause, pagka hindi kami naka one-third, ibig sabihin, ang finding nyo walang probable cause. On the other hand, even if it's a scrap, it's a piece of paper na walang laman, If one-third signs, it will go to the Senate at meron ng probable cause yun. And there was always a unanimity there. Na pagka yung one-third nakapirma, nasa, pumunta na sa amin yon, ang trabaho namin, hindi i-determine yung probable cause. Ang i-determine namin, number one, meron bang impeachable ground? May ground ba for impeachment under the Constitution? Then number two, proceed with trial, whether or not nga guilty yung tao. So, yung po ang problema ko. Assuming I ask for a reconsideration because I voted with the majority and I think the ruling of the presiding officer and of the impeachment court is correct. But assuming for the sake of argument, sabihin natin dapat bigyan ng hearing, dapat payagan ang defense na magpakita ng ebidensya na hindi nagkaroon ng due process or ng probable cause, no? Pero ang constitution na po nagsabi na kapag kayong one-third may nakapirma, due process na yon. Dito na siya magpaliwanag. Ika nga ng mga polis, boss, sa presinto ka na magpaliwanag. Dito po ang sinabi, boss, sa impeachment trial ka na magpaliwanag, wag na sa Committee on Justice. So, Your Honor, my question is, and answer the way you would like to, sir, is, are you saying that unconstitutional ang paragraph 4 or this paragraph is in fact violative of other parts of the Constitution? Kasi if we return this to the lower house, yung effect po will nullifying this mode of elevating an impeachment case to the impeachment court.
Now, I'm through, Your Honor.
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Senator. It is not merely Justice Cuevas exposing that view. It is the Honorable Supreme Court already. In the two cases I have mentioned, the impeachment complaint was filed by at least one-third. And the Supreme Court said that is no exemption
so
from
Your Honor,
the determination of probable
cause. My question is, can the Supreme Court amend the Constitution?
Well, it's not amending. That is the interpretation.
But how can you interpret it any other way? Ang nakalagay po dito, in case a verified complaint or resolution of impeachment is filed by at least one-third of all members, the same shall constitute the article of impeachment.
Correct.
Hindi po nakalagay dito, the House shall now have a hearing and determine probable cause.
Wala rin naman
ho
nakalagay dyan that there is no necessity of determining probable cause.
Nakalagay po, Your Honor, and trial by the Senate shall forthwith proceed.
Yes, but in this jurisprudence it is stated, it can be asserted before the lower house.
Well,
go
ahead, Your Honor.
If it is denied, then you can go to the, even if the impeachment case already filed. And if it's the impeachment court may act on it, either granting or denying. So it is a reconciliation.
Your Honor, I will not answer that statement about the Supreme Court because I think in our ruling, we mentioned about the ruling of Chief Justice Davide in the Estrada trial. But I'll stop there. I thank you for answering those questions. But I just like to put that on record that I support the decision of the court. And I don't think there's any other logical interpretation paragraph 4 which I read. No, I mean, if we're going to interpret it that we require the House to have a hearing, it will be the same as the other paragraphs, Your Honor. But anyway, I will let the in this because of due process and we hear both sides. We hear you're not arguing with me, I'm not arguing with you, but I just want to put that on record, Your Honor.
With due respect, Mr. Senator,
yes.
If we follow that dictum, then there never can a time be when impeachable officers may be immune from impeachment proceedings filed by any disgruntled individual. Because all they have to do is gather at least one-third. And there is no more investigation. There is no more probable cause.
But Your Honor,
it goes direct to the Senate.
That's precise.
If we follow that dictum, that will lead to disastrous consequences.
But Your Honor, if
security of tenure provision will definitely be laid to rest, and it may not be invoked by.